Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Misguide, and whoever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala leave astray, no one could guide.
We bear witness there is no deity worthy to worship except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and we bear witness to indeed Prophet Muhammad alayhi abdullah salam, his final and his last messenger. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to bless Prophet Muhammad and his family, his companion, and whoever followed him until the judgment day. Allahumma ameen. I share with you a couple of verses from the Holy Quran, the first verse from Surah Al-Imran. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala may tell us, O you believe, fear Allah as you should be feared, and die not unless you are in a state of Islam. The second verse from Surah Al-Zumr, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he addressed Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and he did him say, O my servant who acted recklessly against their own self, do not despair to Allah's mercy. Surely Allah will forgive all sin. He is the one who forgives, the most forgiving. My dear brother and sister, Islam, today of khutbah, inshallah, will be about the repentance and the performing the righteous deed in the month of Ramadan. First of all, I would like to wish you all a very happy and blessed Ramadan. Today, brother and sister, another beautiful and blessed day and a very special day. We are in the month of Ramadan, and also we are Yawm al-Jum'ah. So it's a double blessing for us. Brother and sister, many of you have said before the month of Ramadan, Allahumma ballighna Ramadan. We have said that in order we can witness the month of Ramadan. Alhamdulillah, you should say, Alhamdulillah, Alhamdulillah, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accepted your dua and allow you to sit here today and to witness the month of Ramadan. Always remember to thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for this opportunity, because He has taken from other people, they are not sitting with us, and they are with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Also, brother and sister, I would like to remind you, like to share this dua with you. Allahumma a'inna fiha ala siyam wal qiyam wa taqabbalahu minna, Allahumma ameen. May Allah help us. May Allah help us to fast and pray and accept it from us, Allahumma ameen. Also, brother and sister, we need to do another dua. And this is also very, very important dua. Allahumma ballighna laylatul qadr. Because why I'm saying that, brother and sister, I'm sure you agree with me, there is a few people. They have started the month of Ramadan, and they are among you, among us, with us here on earth. And they not going to see Laylatul Qadr. So may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala allow us to witness the most important night, which is Laylatul Qadr. Allahumma ameen. Brother and sister, the month of Ramadan is, as you know, is one of the most important months for all mankind. We need to pay attention to this month because it could be our last month. Brother and sister, this is the month we review our Islamic beliefs, and this is when we expand our knowledge. This is the month of ibadah. This is the month of siyam. This is the month of maghfirah. This is the month where is nuzul al-Quran. So we need to pay attention to that month, day and night, and do not let it pass until you fulfill what you need to do, and may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept our dua in this month. What did Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he tell us about this month? He tell us, brother and sister, شهر رمضان أوله رحمة أوله رحمة وأوصله مغفرة. And we are in the middle of the month, by the way. This is the second week. أوصله مغفرة ويغفره عبد من النار. The Prophet said, the beginning of Ramadan is mercy, and in the middle is forgiveness, because you already earned some good deeds in the middle. And then in the end of it is protection from the hellfire, because you earn way more good deeds, and hopefully we witness Laylatul Qadr, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accepted our dua and accepted our siyam, and then there will be acting in the Nar, Allahumma ameen. Also, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he tell us, كان يقول, الصلوات الخمس والجمعة إلى الجمعة ورمضان إلى رمضان مكفرات ما بينهن إذا اجتنبت الكبائر. What does that mean? The Prophet said, whoever pray the five daily prayers and pray from Jum'ah to Jum'ah and fast from Ramadan to Ramadan, all all his minor sin will be erased. Do not be confused, brother and sister. We said the minor sin. So you have to tell al-kabair. Brother and sister, ma hiya al-kabair, the big sin. You have to stay away from it. Because I don't want you to fool yourself, you indulge yourself in sin and say, well, next Jum'ah is coming, I'm going to clean everything up. Or next Ramadan is coming, and there is a difference between minor sin and major sin. I'm going to share with you the major sin is, of course, associating anyone with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala or taking someone else's life unjustly, killing someone. That's, of course, this is a major sin. Or taking the wealth of the orphans for no reason, or committing adultery, or neglecting and disrespecting your parents. It's a major sin. So make sure you stay away from this major sin, brother and sister. Also, I'd like to bring your attention how important the month of Ramadan is. It's the only month you can say, I can fulfill my five pillar as Muslim. More better than any other month. In the month of Ramadan, brother and sister, what do? We fast, that's one. And then we pay zakat, that's number two. And we pray. And also we are sitting and praying, and we say, At-tashahud, ashhadu an la ilaha illallah, wa ashhadu anna rasulullah. So what are we missing? Al-Hajj. So you are forfeiting almost your five pillar in the month of Ramadan, better than any other month. Because the Hajj, brother and sister, if you are ill and you cannot afford it, you are exempt. You don't have to do Hajj unless you can afford it and you are healthy and you can go there and then you can do it. Otherwise, then you could consider yourself, I have fulfilled my obligation every year. My dear brother and sister, we need in every year comes in and every Ramadan comes in, you need to check your books and to see what you have done in the last Ramadan. And you need to increase heavily in this Ramadan than more than last Ramadan. Why am I saying that? I want to bring your attention, every one of us is being dedicated certain amount of Ramadan from the day you were born, you're going to be witnessing. And then every Ramadan passes behind you, you lost one Ramadan, and it's gone from your history, from the time that you've been dedicated. Every one of us has been dedicated 50 Ramadan, 90 Ramadan, 30 Ramadan, and that's all you're going to witness. And then your name will be called to meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So every Ramadan passes, you get closer to your destination to meet Al-Hayy Al-Qayyum Al-Wahid Al-Ahad Allah. So what you need to do, brother and sister, to improve, check how much zakat did you pay last Ramadan? How much Quran did you recite and also memorize? How much good deeds did you do the last Ramadan? I want to be the last Ramadan. Take notes if you have to. Also, brother and sister, what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us about the month of Ramadan. And when it comes in your mind, soon as you hear the word of Ramadan, most of us, it immediately triggers in siyam. Immediately. Most of us, as soon as you hear Ramadan, I'm going to fast if Ramadan is coming. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us differently in the Holy Quran. When you hear about the word Ramadan, the month of Ramadan is here, you need to remember Nuzul al-Quran, the revelation of the Quran, according to the Quran al-Kareem. بعد بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم شهر رمضان الذي أنزل فيه القرآن هدى للناس وبينات من الهدى والفقان. The month of Ramadan is the month the Holy Quran was revealed as guidance to mankind. And a clear proof between to help us understand between right and wrong. This is the first thing that comes to your mind, Nuzul al-Quran in this holy month of Ramadan. And brother and sister, the revelation, you know, it came to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. First of all, it came over the course of 23 years. But the Holy Quran was revealed from the highest heaven to the lowest heaven all at once. And over the course of 23 years, as Rasulullah request came gradually, little by little. According to the Holy Quran here, Surah Al-Isra, Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, وَقُرْآنًا فَرَقْنَاهُ لِتَقْرَاهُ عَلَى النَّاسِ عَلَى الْمُفْهِمْ وَنَزَّلْنَاهُ تَنْزِيلًا. We have divided the Holy Quran, this portion, that you may recite it to the people little by little. Brother and sister, the Holy Quran is the only book can be and it is memorized by 10 and 15 years old kids. There is no other books on the planet Earth that can compare to the Holy Quran. And what's in the Holy Quran for us? We need to open the Holy Quran and especially in the month of Ramadan and see what's in it for you. What's in, brother and sister, everything you need while you live on earth and guidance is in it. And I'm going to mention some of them. Marriage, divorce, family ties, inheritance, business law, biology, science, social justice, medicine, and much, much more. You will find it. Whatever problem that you're facing, open the Holy Quran and search. If you need an answer, you will find inshallah in the Holy Quran. Brother and sister, there is now the month of Ramadan, there is a lot of benefits for us. Multiplication of the good deeds in the month of Ramadan, in having than any other month, is to strengthen our iman and faith, guidance and devotion, forgiveness and repentance is accepted in the month of Ramadan more than any other month. And also it unites us and we meet new people. Look at in Ramadan, in Taraweeh or Salat al-Eid, you find the masjid is over full, alhamdulillah. So what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He ordered us to do in the month of Ramadan is to fast. Is to fast. And what He tells us in Surah Al-Baqarah, by Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, Ya ayyuha al-ladhina amanu, kutiba alaykum al-siyamu kama kutiba ala al-ladhina min qablikum, la'allakum tattaqoon. Another word, when we fast, we should obtain taqwa, brother and sister. Taqwa. What is taqwa, brother and sister? Is God hearing, is to be obedient to Allah, and not to do bad deeds, and to increase from your good deeds, and stay away as far as you can from the bad deeds. That's the taqwa, brother and sister. And you need to remember that there is a judgment day. And then the following verse, أَيَّامًا أَيَّامًا مَعْدُودَةً فَمَنْ كَانَ مِنْكُمْ مَرِيدًا أَوْ عَلَى سَفَرٍ فَعِدَّةٌ مِنْ أَيَّامٍ أُخْرَى. This certain days that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He built us to fast in the month of Ramadan, and then whoever is sick or ill, he can do it some other time, but you have to make up for it. وَعَلِّ الَّذِينَ يُطْلِقُونَهُ فِيَّةٌ طَعَامُ مِسْكِينَ فَمَنْ تَطَوَّعَ خَيْرًا فَهُوْ خَيْرٌ لَهُ وَأَنْ تَصُومُوا خَيْرٌ لَكُمْ إِن كُنْتُمْ تَعْلَمُونَ. Hey, brother and sister, whoever unable to fast, you must feed a miskin. And from outside what you are eating. For example, if you are eating steak and lobster, all those high meat and stuff like that, you cannot go give the poor person a piece of bread and you feed him, or a piece of bread and cheese or a hamburger, and here you are eating steak and lobster every meal almost. You have to feed them whatever you are eating. If you are eating very, very small meal, and then you feed from that. And this is what you can afford. So brother and sister, in the month of Ramadan, we need to always take it as it could be your last Ramadan. Remember when Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when he was doing Khutbah al-Wida, he exerted himself because he had a feeling that it could be his last khutbah. And sure enough, it was his last khutbah al-Wida. And then I want you to take the month of Ramadan in the event your health is not there, or you have hint from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in your dreams. So exert yourself and try to pretend that the month of Ramadan, it could be your last one, and you will inherit tons of good deeds because it will help you in the judgment day. Now, brother and sister, fasting. A lot of us, we see fasting is very easy. Abstaining from food and drinking, no problem. And abstaining from sexual contact with your wife and staying from that is easy. Now, a lot of us, they do that, But they break every other rules: lying, cheating, gossiping. No, you need to be fasting, brother or sister, from all these forbidden things, along the food and the drink. We cannot be gossiping, we cannot be cheating, we cannot be lying, and we cannot be staring at women, and then we are saying, we are fasting. But you are really, you're not fasting correctly, brother or sister. We need to fast all the way for everything that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forbid us not to do. You have to stay with it as far as you can. And this is like a training wheel for us during the month of Ramadan. And then after Ramadan, do not go back to your old habits. See, I'm done with Ramadan. Now I, what did we learn? This is like a training wheel. You have to continue until the following Ramadan. And also, brother and sister, fasting, it teaches us to be patient. It teaches us to be generous. And also teaches us to be under, to control our habit. And the tolerance in case there is food shortage. They're so, and also healthy for us. So how can we break our fast? Many of us, brother and sister, we soon as the event comes in, we start eating as much as we can. Now it's time for you to do wudu and to pray maghrib. I'm unable to. Why? I lost control. Well, you lost one of the benefits of fasting, brother. So you need to control yourself. Soon as the event, you can break your fast on dates, some milk, some soup, and then go ahead and pray and maghrib. And then you can eat just a little bit, and then continue with Isha, and then continue with Tarawih, and then after that, go ahead and eat, and take your time, and eat well. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he tell us, one third food, and one third liquid, and one third air. This way you can be able to move around and not to miss Tarawih or to miss Salat al-Isha. Because I know a few people, they get carried away and they pray a couple of rak'ah Tarawih and say, I'm sorry, I can't, my stomach is full. And then here you lose some of the benefit. So brother and sister, the month of Ramadan is like a big sale for us. We need to take advantage of this big sale and obtain as much as we can. About, and you must pay your zakat. And let me tell you about when you should pay your zakat. First of all, can you go and ask a poor person to loan you $15 or $30 or $1,000 for 30 days? A poor person, you're going to say, you know, he's poor. How can I? How can I want to go ask a rich person. So you're not going to ask a poor person to give you a loan for 30 days. You already dedicated, maybe some of you before the month of Ramadan, that you're going to give to the needy and the poor $50, $100, or I give to the masjid $1,000. But why do you want them to wait for you for 30 days and it's already their money's been dedicated to them before the month of Ramadan started? Why do you make them suffer, especially the needy and the poor, and also the masjid? My suggestion, brother and sister, be soon as the Ramadan starts. If you have not done it, please do it as soon as possible. Or next Ramadan, pay your zakat from the first day. Because it's no longer your money, it's their money, but you have it in your own pocket. You borrow from them for 30 days, or you borrow from the masjid for 30 days. If you have the money, sure, yes. If you don't have the money and you have to wait for it, by all means, do it when you can. أقول قولي هذا واستغفر الله لي ولكم فاستغفروه إن الله هو الغفور الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على أشرف المرسلين وخاتم الأنبياء سيدنا محمد عبد الله ورسوله. Brother and sister, every one of us is a sinner. There is no if, there is no argument over that. We have sinned in the past, and we're going to sin in the future. So what you need to do, brother and sister, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam tell us, كُلُّ بِآدَمِ خَطَّى وَخَيْرُ الْخَطَّئِينَ التَّوَّابُونَ. So every one of us is a sinner. So what you need to do is take advantage of this holy month and ask for repentance. Ask for repentance. It's accepted a lot easier for us in the month of Ramadan more than any other month. And how can you be forgiven? Number one, you need to admit that you did wrong, especially with major sin. You have to admit what you have done wrong. And you need to repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to ask for forgiveness. And then also, you have to have the intention that you're not going to go back to the same mistake again. You have to have a covenant with Allah that I'm not going to go back to it again. Forgive me. And inshallah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will forgive you. Let me share with you from Surah Al-Tahrim, by the Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا تُوبُوا إِلَى اللَّهِ تَوْبَةً نَصُوحًا عَسَى رَبُّكُمْ أَنْ يُكَفِّرَ عَنْكُمْ سَيِّئَاتِكُمْ He did not say مِنْ سَيِّئَاتِكُمْ There's a big difference between سَيِّئَاتِكُمْ or مِنْ سَيِّئَاتِكُمْ سَيِّئَاتِكُمْ He will erase it totally. If he said مِنْ سَيِّئَاتِكُمْ He's going to leave some for you that you have to get it later. So, سَيَّأْتِكُمْ وَيَدْخِلُكُمْ جَنَّاتٍ تَجْرِي مِنْ تَحْتِهَا الْأَنْهَارُ O you believe, turn to Allah and have a sincere repentance that your Lord will forgive your bad deeds and allow you to enter paradise. Allahumma amin. Also, brother and sister, you can exchange your bad deeds in the month of Ramadan to good deeds easier than any other month. You can exchange your bad deeds with Allah easier in the month of Ramadan than in other month. Let me share with you from Surah Al-Furqan, بعد بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم إِلَّا مَنْ تَابَ وَآمَنَ يُرِي آمَنْتِ بِاللَّهِ وَعَمَلَ عَمَلًا صَالِحًا فَأُولَئِكَ يُبَدِّلُ اللَّهُ سَيِّئَاتِهِمْ حَسَنَاتٍ Look at how beautiful it is. يُبَدُّ اللَّهُ سَيِّئَاتِهِمْ حَسَنَاتٍ وَكَانَ اللَّهُ غَفُورًا رَحِيمًا Here, except those who repent and believe in Allah and do righteous deeds. Okay, repent and you do righteous deeds. Like what? Start with your masjid, brother and sister. Help your masjid. Help the poor. Pay for a water well in an African country. But الْأَقْرَبُونَ أَوْلَى الْمَعْرُوفِ Start with your own masjid, which we really need your help and support. And inshallah, I'm going to be talking about it heavily after Salatul Jum'ah. We're going to give you some good news. So I would like to ask each one of you, please, to remain seated after that. So brother and sister, also, I would like to share with you a dua before I close that I enjoyed. I believe I have shared it with you, but I'm going to share it again. From Surah Ibrahim alayhi salam, which is number 14, which is verse 40. رَبِّ جَعَلْنِي مُقِيمَ الصَّلَاةِ رَبِّ جَعَلْنِي مُقِيمَ الصَّلَاةِ وَمِنْ ذُرِّيَّتِي رَبَّنَا وَتَقَبَّلْ دُعَاءِ رَبَّنَا اغْفِرْ لِي وَلِوَالِدَيْ وَلِلْمُؤْمِنِينَ يَوْمَ يَقُومُ الْحِسَابُ What this is a beautiful, beautiful dua if you try to memorize it. When you go home, again, 14, which is the Surah Ibrahim, chapter 40. This is all what you need. What it means? Oh my Lord, make me the one to perform salah, and also my offspring, my children. And our Lord, accept my dua. Our Lord, forgive me. You're concerned about yourself now. And my parents, and all the believers, which is every one of you. And who said this dua? Ibrahim alayhi salam. Look at how beautiful that dua. إن الله عليك يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد كما صليت على سيدنا إبراهيم وعلى آل سيدنا إبراهيم وبارك على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد كما باركت على سيدنا إبراهيم وعلى آل سيدنا إبراهيم في العالمين إنك حميد مجيد وقال ربكم ادعوني أستجب لكم اللهم أهل علينا شهر رمضان بالأمن والإيمان والسلامة والإسلام والتوفيق لما تحب وترضى اللهم اعنا على الصيام والقيام وقراءة وحفظ القرآن اللهم تقبل صيامنا وقيامنا وقنا عذاب النار اللهم احفظ المسلمين والمسلمات الاحياء منهم الاموات يا منزل الماء من السماء يا مخرج النبات من الارض اعف عنا وتقبلنا بواسع رحمتك يا رحمن يا رحيم يا مالك يوم الدين يا قوي يا عزيز يا جبار ادخلنا الفردوس الاعلى اللهم امين عباد الله ان الله يامر بالعدل والاحسان وايتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون اذكروا الله يذكركم واشكروه على نعمه يزيدكم Before I say after Salah, I would like to ask each one of you kindly, please remain seated. I would like to share with you some good news about your masjid. It is our responsibility to hear the good news and see what is your masjid asking you. After Salah.
الله أكبر الله أكبر أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وأشهد أن محمدا رسول الله حي على الصلاة حي على الفلاح قد قامت الصلاة قد قامت الصلاة الله أكبر الله أكبر لا
الله السلام عليكم ورحمة الله السلام عليكم ورحمة الله
My dear brother and sister, السلام الله عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. Please remain seated. This is a very important message. Wallahi, more important than your work. I know everyone has to work, but you know, remember what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَمَا خَلَقْتُ We have been created is to worship Ar-Rahman Ar-Rahim al-Wahid Allah. So let us sit down with us here and let's hear the good news, inshallah. My dear brother and sister, I would like to take you back when we first started here. I remember I met here with Brother Bilal and also Brother Nasser. And this place was closed up. It used to be a church. Some of you you're already aware of that, and some of you have no idea. You think this place is just happened by itself like this. No. People have to make things happen. Things does not happen by itself. So we asked how much this place is, this building. It used to be a church. 1,250,000. Whoa. 1,250,000. Where are we going to get this money from? It's a big task. It's like a big mountain. We had to take it from the bottom all the way up. And alhamdulillah, with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's permission and guidance, we were able to go climbing up, and now we are going down from what we started. 1,450,000. So, brother and sister, we had to get a loan for a good loan from an Islamic bank. It was $625,000. We get that loan, alhamdulillah. And now, guess what is left from the 1,250,000 left? And whose responsibility is this? Every person said, La ilaha illallah, Muhammad Rasulullah, which each one of you. Now we have left $405,000. Takbir.
Allah.
Takbir.
Allah.
Look at that. Look at that. Is this happening by itself? No. Eight the righteous brother and sister, you guys made it happen. So let us continue together, and let us finish this in the month of Ramadan. There is no, guys, you heard it, and you know, I did not tell you something new today. It's a reminder. Every one of you knowledge and know the month of Ramadan is the month to collect hasanat. Don't wait, brother and sister, until the end of the month. Why I should wait, or he should wait with the management for the end of the month. You could commit today and say, brother, I don't have the money, but I'm going to commit for $10,000 or $5,000, and I'll pay as soon as I get the money. Or if you have it, and then say, I'll take care of it right now. So I'm going to start, you know, and let me tell you something. A lot of us sometimes you are shy and be so humble, you don't want to raise your hand. Please raise your hand and say, I'm going to donate. Why? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is at least 5-6 times the following. قُلْ لِعْبَادِيَ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا يُقِيمُوا الصَّلَاةَ وَيُنْفِقُوا مِمَّا رَزَقْنَاهُمْ سِرًّا وَعَلَانِيَةً I'm not telling you anything you don't know. I'm just reminding you. سر وعلانية من قبل أن يأتي يوم لا بيع فيه ولا خلال. أنظر سورة البقرة: الذين ينفقون أموالهم بالليل والنهار سرا وعلانية فلهم أجرهم عند ربهم ولا خوف عليهم ولا هم يحزنون. So do not be shy, do not be so humble, because when you raise your hand, you're going to ignite the day and help others to raise and follow your footsteps. Who is the lucky person who's going to take this dua? Ya Rabbil Alameen. Ya Rabbil Alameen. Adhil Jannah wa Hashur Ma'a Rusul Anbiya. The first person raised his hand, Ya Rabbil Alameen. Who can raise his hand for $10,000, inshaAllah? Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim wa bihi nasta'in. And now I'm going to do massive dua for you. I want you to, brother and sister, it is our responsibility. It's not the United States government's responsibility. It is every one of us. Allahu Akbar, takbir. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless you and reward you and protect you. We have to make a jannah. You and everyone you love, Allahumma ameen. Allahumma ameen. Allahumma ameen. Who could follow this jannah as well for $10,000? Wallahi, wallahi, he didn't need it. And he's going to get baptized. Do not wait for tomorrow, because you may not see tomorrow. Wallahi, you may not see tomorrow. Don't wait for the last minute. So brother Bilal and others, please pass this pledge form to everyone sitting here right now. Brother Bilal, please pass this form to everyone around here with pens. Give them a pen and paper, and they will write down whatever they desire. Could you please pass around everyone? They are sitting here waiting for us. So God bless each one of you sitting here. Ya Rabbil Alameen, meet you to sit next to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. You are sitting and waiting to donate. Others, some of you are left and they have other things to do. I understand. But God bless each one of you that you are sitting here. Brother and sister, let me share with you from Sultan al-Munafiqun. وَأَنْفِقُوا مِنَّا رَزَقْنَاكُمْ مِنْ قَبْلِ أَنْ يَأْتِيَ أَحَدُمَ الْمَوْتِ فَيَقُولَ رَبِّ لَلَّا أَخَّرْتَنِي إِلَىٰ أَجَلٍ قَرِيبٍ فأصدق وأكون من الصالحين. Here Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He knows when your time comes or you are on the bed of death and you're going to die, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows exactly what you're going to say. Give me time to do what? To do Hajj? To pray? No, as-sadaqah, which is sadaqah jaleel. Please pass the form to every person sitting with a pen. And also, before I start it, I have a one generous brother right here sitting on the chair. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless him and reward him and protect him. Allahumma ameen. Say ameen. He gave me a check for $2,500. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala let him lack a jannah. Allahumma ameen. How much, brother? I'm sorry? 20,000? Allahu Akbar. Takbir. Takbir. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless you and reward you and protect you. We have to make a jannah. You and everyone you love, say it as loud as you can. Ameen.
Ameen.
Ameen. Allahumma taqabbal rabbil alamin. Yawm al-jum'ah from Allah. Allahumma taqabbal hadha du'a. Sincerely coming from my heart to you and your family. Allahumma ameen. $20,000. So who else, inshallah? Can I see another thing, inshallah? Is that how much better? 5,000. Takbir. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless you and reward you and protect you. We have to bless Jannah, you and everyone you love. Allahumma ameen. Say ameen, please say
ameen.
Be generous when you say ameen. This way, you know, it motivates us and helps us. So who else could? 5 or 10,000. I'm open for 5 or 10,000, inshallah.
There's 5,000.
5,000? Where is he?
He's not here.
He's not here. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless you, brother. What do you say?
He does not have mission name. He does not have mission name.
Okay. Whoever, $5,000. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala yakbul laka jannah. Allahumma yakbul laka jannah. You and everyone you love. في هذا اليوم المبارك أن تبارك في هذا الدعاء يا أرحم الراحمين يا الله. Who else? 5,000? Anyone 5,000 before we go down to list? 5,000. If you can afford it, and you can take it on payment, or you can pay clear before the month of Ramadan. Anyone? Okay. How much are
5,000?
Another 5,000. 5,000. Takbir. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Is he? Is he here?
He's here.
Don't mention the name. Okay. Don't mention the name. Allah knows who you are. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless you and reward you and protect you. Allahumma ameen. Allahumma ameen. Another 5,000. So, brother and sister, how many of you can afford, if you say, only $3,000? Three. 3,000 inshallah. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim.
No, don't go down yet. We have another 5,000.
Allah, Allah, Allah. We have another 5,000. Yeah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless you and reward you and protect you. Whoever you are, brother and sister. You could also, brother and sister, give in the simplicity on your behalf of your mother or your father. Yes?
3,000.
Huh?
3,000.
3,000, that be it.
Allah.
May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless you and reward you and protect you. Whoever you are, $3,000. Allah
is the Lord.
Allah, ya Rabb, ya Rabb. لهم جنة واعف عنه رب العالمين. Brother and sister, let me share with you what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala he told Prophet Isa alayhi salam. He asked, he ordered him to do something. What is it? وَجَعَلَنِي مُبَارَكًا أَيْنَمَا كُنْتُ وَأَوْصَانِي بِالصَّلَاةِ What? وَالزَّكَاةِ That's like a little kid. وَالزَّكَاةُ مَا دُمْتُ Hayya. Allah is going to be a See, he also Rasulullah to do the things as long as he's lived, that he has to pray and to pay zakah. And as long as your heart is beating, you must continue giving. So how many of you, brother and sister, could spend fi sabilillah, not 3,000,
another 5,000?
Another 5,000. And Allah is going down fast also, inshallah. Allah, you have to read his name. I love you. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless you and reward you and protect you for another $5,000. We have to bless al Jannah. You and everyone you love, please say loud. Ameen.
Ameen.
Ameen. Allah taqabbal hadha du'a. He has a generous brother right there. So, anyone, okay, how about brother and sister? You can afford Allahu Wahid, Allahu One. Okay, how many of you can afford $1,000 fi sabilillah? Here's one. May Allah, here's two.
Two thousand.
Okay, please give it the form below. And here we have your brother here, 1,000 and 2,000 right there. Yes.
How many years?
1,000. Brother Ibrahim. God bless you. And like a gentleman, I miss your beautiful voice in today. Yes.
We get 10,000.
10,000?
Yes, 10,000.
Alhamdulillah. Come down to pray. Did you come back up? Alhamdulillah. Which one? Who?
He's not here. Brother Muhammad and Brother Muhammad.
Assalamu alaikum. God bless you. We have to make a Jannah, Brother Muhammad. Right, Muhammad?
Yeah.
Rabbi, Ya Rab, hutta ki shoulder to shoulder to Rasulullah Muhammad. Allahumma taqabbal hadha du'a wa ta'ala. We have to make a Jannah. Another 10,000 dollars. So who is the brother and sister?
Allah.
How much?
1,000.
Allah Akbar. Takbir. 1,000. Yeah, 1,000. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless you and work you and protect you among my being. Who else? Brother and sister, do not exclude yourself from this sadaqa jariyah. From this sadaqa jariyah, we need your help and support, inshaAllah. How much? 1,000. Allahu Akbar. Takbir. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless you and reward you in the form, please. Brother Black, give that generous brother. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless you and reward you and protect you. We have to make a agenda. Please say ameen.
Ameen.
Allahu Akbar. Okay, who else, inshallah? Yes.
Brother Rahim Balak, and then from Ismail Balak. 2,500. 2,500.
Who?
Ibrahim Talib.
Ibrahim Talib. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, brother Ibrahim.
He's made Adan or Malik.
Oh, 2,500.
Yes.
But he already gave me another 1,000. Additional. Oh, no. Okay. Another Ibrahim. Okay. 2,500. 500? Jamal Yahid, $500, takbir. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless you and protect you. We have to bless you al Jannah, Allahumma ameen. Ya Rahman, Ya Rahim. Ya Rahman, Ya Rahim. Taqabbal hadha du'a fi hadha al-yawm al-mubarak. Wa antu barik, Ya Rabbil Alameen, for everyone participating and everyone staying here, Ya Rabbil Alameen, Allahumma ameen. Anyone else, inshallah, before I say, Assalamu alaikum. Brother and sister, how much? 1,000, Allahu Akbar, takbir. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless you, brother, and protect you. We have to let Jannah, please say ameen. Let him hear it, brother and sister. Who else before I go? Before I say salam alaykum. Anyone else? We need your help and support to finish the loan, inshallah, in the month of Ramadan. We need to pay off the loan. And also the brother and sister here on the internet, on Facebook Live, you can give me a call, and then I will tell you how we plan. You can donate to Sayyidillah. This way we can take care of this loan. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless each one who is watching us right now on Facebook Live. Allahumma ameen. So here, who else? Anyone else before I say salam alaykum? I would love to do the dua. And also, I know the sister is doing it.
I'm sure my both of the sister's side here shall be doing some good job, inshallah.
Oh, okay. So, brother and sister, if you can afford $1, please include yourself. Do not leave this masjid unless you put $1 into the box. You say, I included myself, I put what I can, and that $1, it could be even better than $50,000. So go ahead and put something in the box on behalf of your father, behalf of your mother. So brother Gladi, is anyone else before I say salam alaikum? 500, Allah has protect me. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless you and reward you and protect you. $500. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, I love that. Yeah, just fill the form, $500. Allahumma taqabbal minka rabbil alameen. Allahumma ameen, Allahumma ameen, Allahumma ameen, ya arhamar rahimin.
Jazakumullah khairan.
Okay, now, I'm going to say for now, salamullah alaykum, wa salamullah ala everyone watching us on Facebook Live, and please remember us in your dua, Allahumma ameen, wa salamullah alaykum.